second installment of our Sacred Music Concert Series. We started this last year, and it is the first major concert of our school year. So this is our second one, and we're so grateful that we could be in this beautiful space. So thanks so much to Rockland Community Church for hosting us and allowing us to present this beautiful music to you here today. So this music is given to you as a gift, and we appreciate that you are here, and we really hope that this music will draw you closer to our Lord Jesus Christ. It's a great piece to start off with by Arvo Pärt, Adam's Lament, and then followed by the Bach Magnificat. So we will perform these without an intermission, but the time won't be so long that you won't be able to endure that. So thank you so much for being here. And I'd like to open us in a word of prayer. Please pray with me. Father, thank you for the gift of music, for how in music and through music that we are creative beings in the image of our Creator. Thank you that you've given us music to praise you with. Thank you that you inhabit that praise. And dear Lord, we ask that you inhabit this space here today. So we give it back to you as our offering of praise and thank you for your presence. In Jesus' name, amen. Now it's my real pleasure to introduce to you Dr. Megan DeVore, who will come and give you kind of a pre-concert talk about these pieces. Dr. DeVore is one of our faculty members in the School of Theology. So please welcome Dr. Megan DeVore.
Tonight, a sacred music narrative, a story for our ears and mind and heart and soul. This experience juxtaposes an intense duo, two dramatic, evocative scores, both inspired by scenes from the Bible. As you'll soon hear, though, they couldn't contrast more. In musical composition and technique, in inspiration, scriptural subject, gesture, and in our heart's response. Are we ready for the journey? For these exquisite performers to be our guide? First, we'll hear a work fashioned in our own era by the Estonian composer Arvo Pärt. Here, innovation meets tradition, as Pärt combines striking contemporary musical innovation with whispers of inspiration and technique from eras past. The result will be an evocative, nearly overwhelming soundscape where intense emotion meets profound introspection. This is not limited to compositional method alone. Pärt has put to music a poem written nearly a century ago by the monastic Silwan of Athos. In the words of this poem titled Adam's Lament, Silwan enters into the scriptural tragedy of Genesis 3, imagining Adam's verbal response to that which was shattered by the fall, by the choice to grasp and partake in the fruit which was not meant to be partaken. When the Creator's emphatic, "You shall not," was met with the creature's impatient, "We will." Silwan's poem is a tragedy of lament, an evocative cry that speaks not only of loss of communion with God in the garden, but is foretelling of the strife and suffering Adam's children would forever know. Here, the darkness is descending. As we listen, immersed in Pärt's vivid, bleak soundscape, Adam weeps at this brave new world, and we begin to mourn at our world. We find ourselves drawn in utterly, and as the last line surveys Adam's land shadowed by death, we groan with Pärt's dirge at Silwan's final line. I too have lost grace, and call with Adam, "Be merciful to me, O Lord." were the evening to end with this, we might remain in our seats, stunned, with silence, and with grief. What can be done? We are Adam. We are human. Our world makes us weep, daily, if we let it. And were this to be all, we would walk out of this building, like Adam, to a landscape of death after death after death. But the evening will not end with this. We are not left with this. For Jesus Christ was the new Adam, God who entered into humanity as one of us, born and maturing, dying and defeating death, restoring our life and our communion with the one who created us. If you find yourself only in the world of Adam's lament, if you are in a place where you only know of death, where you only mourn, where you only feel alone, if you long for light and restoration and hope tonight, please reach out to a member of the CCU School of Music. They will sit with you and listen to you and mourn with you, but then they will tell you about restoration. And it is restoration that the second piece is what we hear tonight. It will be magnificent. Composed by Johann Sebastian Bach in the 18th century, the Magnificat is nothing less than jubilation. Through the different movements, this canticle will lead us, no, it will immerse us in Mary's song in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1. With complex intervals, at times evocative of courtly dance, at times conjuring a herald's trumpet, with choral exclamations, introspective arias, and duets, the Magnificat at once humanizes Mary and emphasizes that we and every generation are implicated in the wonder now of salvation. As we follow the trajectory of Mary's verbal dance, we listen as she rejoices in the present, glorifies at God's work, then looks ahead with hopeful, careful wonder as to what this will mean for the future, then looks back at the distant past with effervescent gratitude for God's fulfillment of every single promise. Truly, the tears are wiped from our faces. From the very first words, Magnificat anima mea, my soul magnifies, we are led into exhilarating, boundless joy. What a restoration. Mary invokes all generations, that's us, participating in her joy, in her hope, because of what Christ Jesus has done and will do. This changes everything. In these two works, then, we have two sacred narratives, and in them we find ourselves. With Peart's Adam, we cry. The tragedy is the fallout of separation from our Creator, but then God meets us in our mourning. And we, with Bach's Mary, will magnify in wonder and jubilation, in choruses, as we listen to solos, duets, trios, our ears, our hearts, our minds will be compelled with hope and joy again because of Christ. In both works, then, a sonorous narrative is what is in store for us tonight. Well, little did you know, perhaps, what you were walking into. But we'll cease the spoken introduction and let the music immerse us. Enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. we'll do it with the mic turned down, maybe. Good. We want to thank you so much for coming tonight to hear this music. Thank you for supporting us. There is a donation basket just outside the door. As we go, please bow with me in prayer. Our Father, thank you for this time we've had to be together to share this music. Thank you for all of the students and faculty and staff and wonderful guests that we've had share with us today. And we pray your blessing on us as we go from this place. Amen. Thank you.